So you want to make one of these AI art effects. When I tell you it's one of the easiest effects you'll probably ever make, I'm not even playing, let's go. As usual, you're going to open up TikTok Effect House and then click the Art Maker template. If your device is as slow as mine, this might take a hot minute to open up, but don't worry, it will open up. The template's going to open up and nothing's going to happen, but that's because everything is off. So this little Art Maker Try Me thingy over here is the main thing that we're going to be working with. But before that, I just want to show you this little progress bar animation is for if you want like a loading screen while your user is waiting for the effect to like generate. See, it looks like this. You've probably seen it in TikTok before. And then the smoke proof animation is for if you want it to be revealed all dramatically. So instead of just like a before and after, it's like a before, after. All right, so let's switch on Art Maker. As I said before, this is where we're going to be generating our AI image. In the beginning, it might give you some default generated thing like this, but of course you want generated images according to like prompts that you've given to it. So let's do that. So in the inspector over here, you're going to come to this little section called Art Maker, hover over these three dots, right click and hit reset. So after you click on reset, you'll see that all those auto generated things from the beginning are gone, and now you're going to click generate artwork. And then you're going to get logged in to Lord knows where. I'm like assuming it's TikTok, but like I don't know. Once you're logged into this mysterious place, then you're going to be able to create the prompts and the like type of generated art that you want. So let us start with the text prompt. So what you want to do is be as specific as possible, like act like you're giving instructions to a robot, because that's what you're doing. So instead of typing in a prompt like I don't know, like cute, aesthetic, you know, like heavenly, like no, type in I don't know, like halo, angel wings, like things it can actually work with. Otherwise, it's just going to generate any old thing and there won't be any consistency with your effect. Also, the less words you use, the more specific it is going to be. Let me show you what I mean. So with this first prompt, what I'm going to type in is alien, extraterrestrial, monster, gooey, space, creepy, right? So they're all within like generally the same genre. But like these are a buckload of words. Over here you can pick the art style that it's going to be in, and also on page 2 there's cool tones, so don't forget about that. I'm just going to pick fantasy because why not. Text strength is basically asking like, do you want us to super follow the prompts that you gave us, or are you just giving us sort of hints as to what we can do? So if you said like a white glove, can it be sort of off-white, you know, light shades of gray sort of thing? Or do you want a white glove? So the higher the value, the stricter they follow your prompts. And then you're going to test your prompts on different images. And you know my rule around here, test it on different people. So I have a seemingly Caucasian person, a seemingly East Asian person, a seemingly Southeast Asian person, and a seemingly Black person. You can add up to 10 images, so if you're testing it on different people, then you know obviously have a wide range of people. If you're testing sort of poses, then have a wide range of poses and have a couple of JoJo poses in there as well. You're going to need those. And then the last thing is preview count. So with each image, how many previews of the effect do you want? So if it's 4, each image is going to have 4 variations of your effect. And then click on generate image, and then it's going to tell you some fact that you really don't need to know while you wait. It's just a slick way of being put on hold. And there we have the original image and 4 variations of your effect. And remember, the prompts that I put here were like alien, ET, monster, gooey, space, creepy. So they basically just choose any what word to work with and output that. So let me show you what it looks like when you give actual, like clear, non-vague prompts. So these are the results I got for alien, extraterrestrial, monster, gray. And then like check this out, this is the result that I got for skeleton, bones, skull. So super clear, super crisp, cannot get these wrong. As you can see, didn't get them wrong. And then I tested the effect again on our usual TikTok people, so here's how it looked. And I know I've turned us into people who look for grand finales on this channel. So here is how it looks on me.
We don't stop getting paid around here.